Hey guys, welcome to another great episode of the Naruto Breakdown Show. I'm your host, VX Kingpin XV, and today we're doing a double feature. Yes, the manga review. If you've already haven't checked that out, please check that out. And also, I did the episode review. It came out early. The information I had showed that it came out early for the episode, and it was a good one. And what made this one special? Yes, special. Is that this is the end of the fillers. Wow, no more character development. I'm gonna really miss it. No, I'm not. Yeah, that's a lie. I was so excited to know that the fillers were ending. I didn't even take notes and rewatch the episode. I was just floored by the fact that in the preview they showed Naruto and B meeting for the first time. Naruto's like, who is this old guy? Blah, 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 blah. And how wonderful it is that he's going to be learning how to use his Jinjuriki abilities for the first time. Or his, you know, his chakra, his Ninetail chakra, fox power, whatever. So with that being said, we're going to jump right into this episode. Today was a good episode. Actually, it was probably one of the better ones. Of the character development stories, this one was more about Naruto's character development. So this filler was more based off Naruto, his experiences. He drew memories from the past of Jiraiya, Pain, and things that they told him, and saying, you know, he's going to be the one to change what's going on in the future. And I guess I understand why they led with this as being the last filler to go right into the the rest of this arc, the rest of this story of the Fourth Ninja War. And I think they did that mainly because that's what all of these stories, these fillers have been about. Even though they've been fillers, all of them have been dealing with what's currently going on and then them remembering things from the past. It hasn't been just a straight up filler where it's just a random show. It haven't been that. So I'm proud of the writers and that they did that versus what they did in the past. So this story was just about the Stone Village people meeting up to deliver a message to the Mist Village. Mist Village kind of jumped the gun. I think his name was Garinu or something. It's hard to pronounce. But he attacked the Hidden Village, the Stone Village. He attacked the big guy, you know, with the big funny looking nose, and he took him down with one shot. And I was kind of disappointed. I was like, well, they couldn't do better than that. They couldn't, you know, maybe they jumped the gun, maybe they caught him off surprise, but that's what happened. Naruto jumped in, you know, he had just finished eating ramen. You know, he came out and he's like, hey, what's going on? Why are you guys, you know, fighting each other? He jumped in, did some shadow clones. He didn't really get crazy because it wasn't that kind of show. He was just trying to break up the fight. The little guy with the shark teeth. I don't know why he has shark teeth, I'm not really sure. But he had a personal message from the Mizukage, the lava woman. And she basically gave them a trinket of a battle that happened in the past where the Stone Village people, they betrayed the Mist. And the main character of this one, he was harboring all these emotions because of his friend Surin, who died during, you know, she was wanting peace. And he's like, oh, maybe for the first time we're going to have peace. And boom, the Stone Village ended up betraying them. And so 10 years later, you know, he saw this as an opportunity to get revenge. Basically because he doesn't agree with the Shinobi Allied forces. So he was trying to disrupt that, create ripples and things of that nature. But basically Mizukage beat him to it. And the whole point of this was to bring him this trinket of his friend who had died from 10 years previous to kind of just smooth things over. And basically Naruto kind of, before they smoothed everything over, Naruto was like, look, you know, believe in me. I'm going to change the future. It might not happen really fast, but it's going to happen. And, you know, he was kind of listening to Naruto, but basically what happened was the girl that was with them, the other Stone Village character, came in. She was going down to, you know, go in for the kill shot, and Naruto stepped in, and he took the blunt forced trauma of being slashed open, or then it wasn't really that bad. I guess Naruto, you know, kind of it wasn't that big of a deal. But he stopped it, and it made the guy change his mind about trying to be consumed by hatred. And, you know, a lot of that has been happening in these past episodes about, you know, hatred and what's going to happen in the future. And Naruto's going to save the day. You know, this wasn't about Naruto and him being famous, because she kept referring to Naruto as being an underling. Basically, a lonely genin who was a nobody. And she didn't know who he was and how famous he was. The other guy did, from the Mist Village. He knew how important Naruto was. He was like, didn't you want to kill Pain? Didn't you want to have your revenge? Naruto was like, yes, I wanted my revenge. And it was to the point I shook. I was just so frustrated and wanted to kill this guy. And you know, all this hatred inside me, but I didn't, because hatred, more hatred begets more hatred, you know. So he understood that hatred could be a vicious cycle, and he wanted to be the person who ends it. And I think that these are the main focuses of what's going on in the Naruto storyline now. So with that being said, the story ended. Like I said, it was good. It wasn't great. It had nothing to do with what was currently going on in the Fourth Great Ninja War, but we appreciate it. The previews, what's yet to come, kind of starts off with the bang of the eight tails going in the beast mode to stop another octopus, and it was just really tight. They come there in style in a, you know, like some flagship boat or a yacht or whatever, so it's going to be interesting to see why they even have that boat. But other than that, everything was great. Hope you guys enjoyed this breakdown as well. Please continue to rate. Tell me what you guys think. What you guys hope to see out of the new episode? Because, I mean, shit, if you're watching this, I'm excited. You're excited. We can all be excited together. So tell me down below in the comments exactly what you guys think is going to, you know, what they're going to focus on, what other kind of stuff they're going to fill up the space with. And just be excited about it fucking getting back. Give this you know, video a thumbs up. If you like the fact that these fillers, these character development stories are over, give a thumbs up. You know, it really helps me out, makes me understand that you guys like what you've seen. And remember, rate, comment, and subscribe. I do appreciate the new subscribers. I'm going ahead and push both of these out at the same time. And I'm still working on the Jinjuriki, the character development stories that I put out previously. I'm still having computer troubles. I have the blue screen of death on my laptop, so it's hard for me to do the video and kind of read what's going on, and so you guys can get the best of what's out there. So I'll figure out something. I gotta get them done, but it's gonna take a while. Nobody else is doing them, so I'm not worried about it getting out there any faster. But anyways, it's been a real pleasure speaking with you guys again. Please rate, comment, subscribe. Peace.